Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in a Cube. And in this video, we're gonna answer a question from the live stream. Someone asks, can you put a clock in a Power BI report? Can you? Well, in this video, I'm gonna show you. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam this guy. All right, Otto asks, hey, is there a way for you to put a clock in your Power BI report? And there were all kinds of things starts flying up in the chat. Oh, you can use HTML viewer, you can use countdown timers, but he wanted a clock, an actual clock. And so I accepted the challenge. I accepted the challenge and I'm like, instead of all this talking, you know how I would like to do? Let's head over to my laptop. So the first thing I did was I went out to get some custom visuals. So I'm like, this gotta be pretty easy. I mean, it's a clock. Nothing. I was like, well, but people said there was a custom. Well, let me go. You search again. Let me look at timer. Let's look at timer. That's not actually what Otto asked for. He actually wanted a clock. So I started searching the interwebs and I found lots of samples where they created clocks using HTML, hypertext markup language. But the challenge was they were using JavaScript in it. And the HTML content had a slight limitation. Let me show you. So instead of timer, I switched it to HTML. And there's several of them out there, but I know Daniel Marsh Patrick. So I tried this one out. I imported the custom visual, added it to my page, and then I started reading the docs on it. And in the docs, when I went to the limitation sections of it, it says you probably are out of luck if you try to do these things. Externally hosted JavaScript was one of them. So I was like, and to be honest with you, I was like, okay, done. I gave up. I found all these examples, but I can't use them in the HTML custom visuals. So I just abandoned it. A couple of days later, I was on the phone with Pat Mahoney. Said, hey, was watching the live stream and there's actually a way you can do this with Deneb. I didn't even think about Deneb. Pat's all into Deneb. And if you want to get started with Deneb custom visual, Carrie Colosco has great blogs. Pat has some good videos out there also. And there's just tons of content out there on Deneb. Not for me. This is going to be the very first one. And to be honest with you, I'm not doing that much with it, but I want to show you how we easily put a clock in a Power BI report. Check this out. So the first thing I did was I clicked on the ellipsis. I chose get more visuals and I searched for Deneb. And there it goes right there. So I added that. And then I used the link that Pat gave me. It's a example gallery for Vega. Vega is one of the languages you can use inside of the Deneb viewer. You can use Vega or Vega Lite. And he said, scroll down a bit, Patrick. And boom, there's a clock. So I clicked it. And then it's got all the Vega JSON specification for this clock. So I copied it. The funny thing is, I was like, oh, I'm gonna do a video and show people how to do this. Didn't ask Pat any questions. I should have, because I kind of got stuck a little bit. But I went straight and tried to do this on my own. So got this on my clipboard, lots and lots of stuff. Didn't look at it, didn't give it a go, didn't review any of the JSON specification. I just copied it. And then I went over here to my Power BI report and I added that visual to my page. And I was like, what do I do now? So I just kind of tinkered a little bit. I should have read, but when you work in IT, you don't read instructions. And so I clicked this ellipsis and it said edit. I was like, well, all right. But still, it was just documentation. I was like, what do I do now? So I saw that there was this, hey, add some fields. Create a data set you want to work with, add a column. So I created a very simple measure and I added it. And then I went back to edit. And then I had something different, Vega Lite and Vega. So what I did was I chose Vega Lite, click create, deleted everything there, pasted in and ran it. And then I got this error. I was like, oh, what do I do now? So I went back to the report and I thought about it for a second. I was like, oh, wait a minute. On that website, it was actually Vega, not Vega Lite. And so I'm going to go back to my report over here and I'm just going to delete it and start over. So remove, and then I'm going to add it back and I'm going to add that measure back. And then I'm going to click edit. And then choose Vega, not Vega Lite. Click create and paste this in here. And now I'm gonna run it. Boom, there's my clock. And it's ticking, right? So it looks like it defaults to my time zone. And so now this is kind of big and I just kind of started looking through this code. I'm guessing if I change the height and width, I'm gonna shrink this down to 100 here. And I like how it doesn't do anything until you actually click run. So I click here and then I'm gonna run this. Boom, made my clock smaller. So that was exciting. So I'm gonna go back to my report. Oh, look at there, there's my clock. Maybe I need to make it just a little bit smaller. I'm gonna move this up to the top right corner and boom, there's a clock in my report. Otto, what do you think? Is this answer? Does this solve your problem? I hope so. All right, what do you guys think? Have you been working with the NAB before? Vega, Vega Lite, all the JSON specification? I haven't, but you know what? This is sparking an interest, and maybe I'll do some very simple videos on how you get started with Vega and Vega Lite using the NAB. All right, if you have any questions, if you have any comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. You like my video? Big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.